Hi, today on Repairs 101, I'm going to do a little something about valves. So now, this was actually a really difficult video to shoot because the more I thought about valves, the more I realized it's really quite amazing. They're everywhere. Also, the more I thought about all the different kinds of valves.
These are valves. There's a valve in there.
And those are valves.
Here's a valve. That's a valve. Here's three valves that are all essentially the same. The only thing that's different is the plastic cap.
Here's another valve right here.
So this little object here is an adapter for my high pressure compression tester. Now the reason I'm showing you this in this particular case is to show you the valve in the end of it. Funny looking, seemingly broken screwdriver. You might think that you have a broken screwdriver on your hand if you have one of these, but in fact, it's a Schrader valve remover. It just goes in there like that, and then it's threaded. So it just spins right on out. Okay, so that's what a Schrader valve looks like. Pretty cool, eh? Now, if you think you recognize the Schrader valve, and if you think it looks familiar, you're right. Here's some valves out of an engine, and this one still got the valve guide on it.
Now, this monster here, this is a thermostat for very large diesel engines. And just like the little tiny Schrader valve, it's dropped into a pipe or a passageway and it blocks it, and then when it's activated by this wax slug in the back here, the gap opens here and the fluid's able to wash in past it.
Now, ball valve is exactly that. It's a valve, operates by turning a ball inside of a passageway. As you can see, there's a ball valve right there. So that's what a ball valve looks like. Okay, so here's a regulator, and it is a ball valve. And here it comes around the other side. There we go. So that's a ball valve. So now this one's called a petcock. This is the kind of thing you'll find as a drain on the bottom of your car's radiator. Pardon the pun, but your garden variety garden tap. It's a classic stem valve. It's a classic stem valve. It has a flat bushing rather than the domed one that you might have seen in my other video. Okay, so here's a half-inch gate valve. And the gate valve's pretty good. I'll just okay, so here we have another kind of gate valve.
Check it out. This one, the gate swings from side to side.
There's another small one. There, it's another small gate valve. Close the gate. Open the gate again. And yet another kind of gate valve. As you can see, this one, the gate swung open. See up in the top corner here, the gate is swung down and open to let the floodgate open. This little baby's a 3/4 inch check valve. And the check valve is a one-way passage. You can see there's a flapper valve inside. So fluid can flow through in the direction of the arrow very easily, but can't flow the other direction. There's your flapper right there. There's a grease needle with a grease nipple on the end. See, there is a check valve installed in the end of the grease needle. It's just a ball bearing with a tiny little spring behind it. Poke it and release it. There should be a little grease come out of it. There, you see that? Got a little grease out of it. So there's another kind of check valve. It's the ball bearing check valve. I'm not going to open it because I want to be able to identify it and identify its part number. There you go, another ball bearing check valve. Hose would slip on here and you'd have it attached to your fuel can. And when you disconnect it, of course, you don't want the fuel coming out. Spring will push the ball bearing and make a seal on the end.
It's also a check valve. It's called a joker valve. And what's really interesting about it is, aside from the fact that it's made out of rubber and just has sort of an elastic memory that allows material to pass through this way, but of course resists passage of material through this way. And what's interesting about it is, of course, that it's very, very similar in design to the tricuspid aortic and pulmonary valves. Tricuspid, this is a tricuspid, 3 points, aortic and pulmonary valves in your heart. They are essentially the same kind of design, except instead of hard rubber with an elastic memory, your heart valves, of course, are made out of dynamic living tissue.